Dinamo Zagreb have been on the top of the Balkan football, winning a mind-boggling 13 Croatian top-flight league titles from a possible 14. Their triumphs are not limited to Hrvatski Telekom Prva Liga only, they have become a regular Champions League team, even winning brilliantly against Atalanta in a group stage encounter. With a real lack of money, they have focused on their youth academy that has become one of the best in Europe. Named among the 6 best youth academies in Europe, they boast a large number of superstars in football world, including Dejan Lovren, Mateo Kovacic, Robert Prosinecki, and the magician Luka Modric. The academy itself has certain objectives that it tries to reach for all players. These include helping the youngsters to be happy in sport, teaching youngsters the process of developing a healthy lifestyle, teaching responsibility in school, and training their players to be good people in the community. Well, technically speaking, they focus mainly on playing with 2 feet. "We will do everything with 2 feet," one of Dinamo Zagreb's coach said in an interview. However, the stats tell a different story. Kovacic touches the ball using his right foot 96% of the time. Modric and Lovren use their favorite right foot 88% and 79% times respectively. For comparison, Varane uses his right foot only 61% and Santi Cazorla uses it only 68% times. Looking at the stats, it does not look like they were Dinamo Zagreb's product. However, we know that they are. How is it possible then? Kovacic joined the academy when he was 14, Modric when he was 16, and before that they were playing in streets every day and with small academies. Not only this, 6 players out of the starting 11 for Croatia in the World Cup final in 2018 came through Dinamo Zagreb, but 3 of them joined the club when they were 20 or old. And to go further, a list of Dinamo Zagreb's top 10 transfers and the age they joined is as follows. So, we have a top 6 academy in the world with beautifully structured youth system from the age of 6 years and onwards. You would think that spending time in the academy all those years would give you an advantage. But only if their top 10 transfers joined the academy before the age of 15. If the academy really did work, the makeup of the top 10 transfers would be full of kids who were in the academy since they were 8. The heart of the problem in an elite academy or club system, be it Barcelona, Arsenal, MLS academies or your local super team, is that they cannot keep pace with the systems of development players take on when allowed to choose. Kids playing basketball 3v3, the hockey kids playing hour of pond hockey, or the kids playing street soccer with love in their mind pick up. The world's greatest academy is not the best development system. That system is free play. Roberto Ayala, he came to River Plate at 12, before that free play. Captain Argentina more times than anyone else. Andres Iniesta, discovered by genius Melendez at 12, before that free play. 2010 World Cup winner. Ronaldo, free play until 16, World Cup leading scorer of all time. "I was not coached until the age of 16. I believe in play early, learn late." Michael Jordan. The formal technification strategies of Dinamo are important, but perhaps, as in the models described before, only after the requisite free play has been logged, allowing the child and the game to grow together. Waiting allows children to gain the maturity and cognitive skills through play necessary for normal work and prevents them from becoming frustrated and discouraged by attempts to handle material that they are not simply yet ready to understand. When asked about this, Dinamo coaches simply revert, "That is because players are born, not made."